Hey there, adventurers, and welcome back to the Kritter Corner. I'm Hannah, your safari guide, ready to embark on a magnificent journey across the oceans. Today, we are diving into the world of humpback whales. We'll be answering the fascinating question, how far do these gentle giants migrate? Let's dive in. First, let's meet the incredible humpback whale. These amazing creatures belong to a group of whales called baleen whales, which means they have baleen plates in their mouth instead of teeth. Baleen whales are known for their massive size and their unique feeding techniques. You might be wondering, what's the difference between a baleen whale and a toothed whale? Toothed whales, like dolphins and killer whales, have teeth and use echolocation to find and capture their prey, while baleen whales, like the humpback whale, have baleen plates that look kind of like a big broom that filter tiny organisms from the water. Scientists believe that baleen whales eat far more than they previously thought. Scientists now believe that they eat anywhere from 20 to 30 million calories a day, or 10 to 20 tons of food. That would be like a human eating 60 to 70,000 shrimp cocktails in one day. That is a healthy appetite. Humpback whales are incredibly social animals. They live in groups called pods, which can consist of a few individuals or up to 20 individuals. These pods often include their mothers and their calves, who share a strong bond and migrate together. Yes, about migration. Migration is the movement from one place to another, usually for a short time or seasonally. Humpback whales are known for their incredible migration because they travel thousands of miles between their tropical winter breeding grounds and their Arctic summer feeding grounds. These migration journeys vary among the different populations of whales. During the summer months, the whales feast on small animals like krill along the icy coasts of the Arctic and Antarctic oceans. When winter approaches, they leave their feeding grounds behind for warmer water. Most migrate along coastlines, but some make tremendous journeys of thousands of miles across entire oceans. They all end up somewhere closer to the equator in warmer waters. This is where they reproduce and have their babies, which are called calves. These are some big babies though. One calf can weigh close to a ton and be 10 feet long. Both mom and baby will migrate again when winter is over to the Arctic waters to feed again. This journey comes with many dangers, but these gentle giants push against the challenges and accomplish the feat. One of these winter breeding grounds is the Great Barrier Reef off the coast of Australia. Coral reefs play an essential role in humpback whales' lives. These vibrant ecosystems provide food, shelter, and a place for the whales to rest and raise their young. Humpback whales are often spotted near coral reefs. Humpback whale ecotourism has sprouted up in various places around the world. Whale watching cruises or dives with the whales have become very popular. Ecotourism can be an effective conservation tool when done in a respectful way towards the animal. The migration journey isn't the only challenge that humpback whales face, though. They are affected by issues like entanglement in fishing gear and the impacts of climate change on their feeding grounds. Humpback whales are protected by the Marine Mammal Protection Act in the United States. Thanks to global conservation efforts and the Endangered Species Act, the current population has rebounded to nearly 80,000 individuals, up from as little as 10 to 15,000. Legal acts can be another powerful wildlife conservation tool.
Let's recap what we've learned. The humpback whale's scientific name is Megatera novilangliae. Its status is least concern. The habitat is oceans all over the world. They eat fish, plankton, and krill, and their threats are entanglement and climate change.
Humpback whales are incredible species that make one of the biggest journeys of the entire animal kingdom. Let's celebrate them and work together to protect them. Thanks for joining me on this incredible marine adventure. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to learn more about animals here in the Kritter Corner. See you later!